Good afternoon and welcome to the teleconferencing session for the post basic BSc nursing students of Indira Gandhi National Open University. Now that you are having your teleconferencing session for the second time, and we are going to discuss about pediatric nursing and mental health nursing in the subsequent sessions. To begin with, we will have a session from 2:30 to 3:15 on pediatric nursing, and then we will have the tea break from 3:15 to 3:30. From 3:30 to 4:15, we will have a session on again pediatric nursing, but the topics will be different. And then 5 minutes break, and after 5 minutes we'll have the session on mental health nursing. Stay with us throughout because you will have the discussion from experts, and do let us know how many of the students are attending the teleconference. And this is my request to the regional directors, because I must get the attendance of the number of students attending today's teleconference. With this, I would like to introduce my experts today in the studio. On my left we have Dr. Mrs. Pitti Kaul. She is reader in School of Health Sciences and specialized in pediatric nursing. On my right we have got Ms. Surekha Sama, who is working as a registrar at Delhi Nursing Council but has a specialization of pediatric nursing. We are very pleased to have both of you with us, and I'm sure the students are going to have fruitful deliberations from you, and whatever questions you have, do ask them, because they are the experts who can answer all your questions. Try to discuss more on a low birth weight baby in this session, but any other question if you have, you are most welcome to ask. You must have had some of the counseling session by now and read the blocks also, because this is block 1, and the discussion on block 1 might have been over also. So if you have any other questions or any other point which you want to learn more from these experts, do ask them. With this, I think without wasting much of time, let us start on care of the low birth weight baby. We are more concerned about total care of the low birth weight baby, where as a nurse you can manage these babies in the community as well as in the hospital. So you as post basic BSc nursing students must be able to build your knowledge or strengthen your knowledge and skills based on what you learn through the face-to-face learning, in the clinical contact session, and through this teleconferencing session. With this, let us clarify what is a low birth weight baby, Dr. Pitti Kaul?
Thank you, Professor Kapoor. As you all know, birth weight is an important indicator of mortality and morbidity among newborns and infants. Therefore, they need special attention and care of nursing personnel working in hospital and community. So what is this low birth weight? Low birth weight is a baby who weighs 2,500 grams or less at birth, irrespective of gestational age, is a low birth weight baby. The low birth weight baby can be extremely low birth weight, or they can be very low birth weight. When we say they are very low birth weight, that means their weight would be between 1,500 to 2,000 grams. And if they are extremely low birth weight, the weight will be below 1500 grams, between 1001 and 1500 grams. So these low birth weight babies are categorized into three general categories. We say the classification. The first classification is the babies could be either preterm, they could be small for date, and they could be also small for date as well as preterm. So what do we mean by preterm babies? Preterm babies means that these babies' growth, intrauterine growth, is normal. There is no growth retardation, but these babies are born, they were born before 37 weeks of gestation. And if we plot their weight on a standard growth chart, we will see that their growth will be between 10th and 90th percentile. What are small for date babies? Small for date babies are the babies whose intrauterine growth is retarded, but they are born at full term after 37 weeks of gestation, and if we plot their weight will be between 10th and 90th percentile. Then there are babies who are small for date as well as the babies who are preterm. So in these cases, the baby will be preterm as well as the baby will be
small for date.
Baby retarded. Yes. That baby will be growth retarded. Then next we come, what is the incidence of these preterm babies or low birth weight babies? The incidence of these babies is that if we talk about India, in India we have 30 to 40% of the babies are born who are preterm, low birth weight babies. I may again repeat.
Yes.
The low birth weight babies in India are 30 to 40%, and out of these 30 to 40% babies, 8 to 10% babies are preterm. And out of these total 30 to 40% of the babies, 20 to 30% are small for dead babies. So this constitutes a huge chunk of the babies who are low birth weight and also small for dead babies. So I must also say that in India, we don't consider 2,500 as the starting point, because considering the scarce resources and a huge large number of these small for dead babies, the low birth weight babies, and the risks which are involved in care, so we consider 2,000 gram babies as the high risk for attention and high risk for admission to the nursery.
So I think this is very important that these babies who are born in the preterm and they are small in weight and also born, they are small for dead and also, preterm. These are the classifications. But as you said, in India, so many babies are born, between the weight of 18 to 2,000 grams, and we don't even consider the international standards as 2,500 grams. All the more the responsibility of pediatric nurses during the antenatal period, natal period, and postnatal period, while looking after the baby, becomes more important. And but there would be many causes which can be prevented, or where the mother can be educated to prevent those causes, so that they can have the normal term baby and normal weight baby. What are the common causes which lead to preterm?
The causes for these two types of babies are almost similar, but there will be variation in certain areas. So if we talk about preterm babies, the causes would be spontaneous premature onset of the labor, chronic and acute systemic maternal illness, poor socioeconomic status, antepartum hemorrhage, cervical incompetence, bicornuate uterus, multiple pregnancy and congenital malformations, young unmarried mothers, maternal diabetes mellitus, severe Rh isoimmunization. Similarly, if we talk about small for dead babies, the causes of these babies include maternal malnutrition, chronic systemic maternal illnesses, placental dysfunction, toxemia of pregnancy, hypertension, genetic and chromosomal disorders, intrauterine infections, multiple infections, maternal smoking, and narcotic addictions. So you have seen just from this table, almost for both preterms and term babies, maximum categorization of the causes remains the same, but the problems could be different. But what we can see from this table is that the most important cause lies between the mother, the infant or the fetus itself, and also on the placenta. And these causes could be making a vicious circle if we don't take care of one at a time, and then we cannot make a vicious circle so that again and again low birth weight babies are born. Because you have seen the maternal illnesses, the maternal infections, the placental insufficiency, low socioeconomic status, short stature mother, and low weight mother. All these are the most important reasons for low birth weight. So if these are not restricted, if these are not prevented, we are going to produce in future also, if a lady is less than 145 centimeters and less than 40 kg weight, and she gives birth to a girl child, and she will again be a low birth weight, and then subsequent all the problems will be there. So these are some of the important causes which can lead low birth weight babies.
I think it's a very huge responsibility on every woman that when she becomes pregnant, she has responsibility towards taking the pregnancy normal and avoiding all kinds of preventable causes. at least, you know, preventable causes can be prevented. She can take care of them. Those causes which are associated with pregnancy, that may not be within her, domain to control them, but the other causes, what she can control, should control if she wants to produce a normal, healthy baby.
Yes, you are right, Professor Kapoor, but what we can say them is that they must encourage all the pregnant mothers to get registered.
Very important.
So very important, so that they will have at least in various areas, in remote areas, at least they can have minimum 3 visits. And within, during these, all the 3 visits, every problem can be identified of a pregnant mother. And the nursing personnel, if they come across with such registrations or they come such across with the antenatal mothers, they have to advise them regarding the antenatal care. I think they must have already read that the antenatal care is in first year. They have studied in maternal nursing. Yes. Very well written there. So they understand that how they have to take care of the antenatal mother and what advices they need to give so that they can prevent these problems in the newborns or in the mothers.
So if we quickly go through the characteristics, yes, of this newborn baby, and then we can go to the management.
Yeah, we will. I just will go leave through those things, but they are also very important, and then we will be discussing in management in detail. Yes. Mrs. Surekha Sama will discuss in detail. So the important things you note is that between a low birth weight baby and a normal full term baby who is active, you have to identify these babies with certain important characteristics.
There is a call from Jaipur.
Yes, Jaipur.
Yes, Jaipur.
Hello.
Yes,
Jaipur. Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, we are listening.
Hello.
Yes, I am listening, please.
जी मैडम.
जी बताइए.
जी मैडम, मैं ये पूछना चाह रहा था मैडम, ये INC रीजनल सेंटर है ना?
हाँ जी.
तो उसको INC नहीं मिली हुई है मैडम आज तक.
देखिए, रीजनल सेंटर को तो इंडियन नर्सिंग काउंसिल की रजिस्ट्रेशन नहीं मिलती है, वो एक प्रोग्राम स्टडी सेंटर को मिलती है. आप उस चीज में चिंता मत करिए, यूनिवर्सिटी उस चीज को देख रही है. ठीक है, यूनिवर्सिटी उस चीज को देख रही है. और
INC का जो लेटर,
आप उस बात को भूल जाइए. आप पढ़िए, अपना पढ़ाई में देखिए, वो हम प्रोसेस ऑलरेडी काफी देर से शुरू हो चुका है. आपके यहाँ हो जाएगा, कोई चिंता की बात नहीं है. ठीक है.
हेलो. yes? इसमें एक और बोलना था
जी,
कि इसमें जो ये डिग्री जो हमें मिलती है, इसमें पोस्ट बेसिक नहीं आके सीधा BSc नर्सिंग आ रही है.
हाँ ठीक है, वो बात भी डिस्कशन में है, उसको लिख के दिया हुआ है. और यूनिवर्सिटी को उसका UGC से थोड़ा क्लियरेंस की चाहिए जरूरत, वो भी प्रोसेस में है. 4-5 महीने हो गया, उसको भी प्रोसेस में डाला हुआ है. तो ये तो एक एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव प्रॉब्लम्स है, वो सॉर्ट आउट हो रही है. ठीक है.
एक और मैम, की जो RNC है वो रजिस्ट्रेशन नहीं कर रहा है.
देखिए, हेल्थ इज ए स्टेट सब्जेक्ट. अगर आपका स्टेट नहीं कर रहा, तो आपके स्टेट को आप अपनी TNA एसोसिएशन को बोलिए कि उनको परस्यू करें, क्योंकि स्टेट हेल्थ इज ए स्टेट सब्जेक्ट. और अगर उनको पोस्ट बेसिक BSc नर्सेज नहीं चाहिए, आप क्यों रजिस्ट्रेशन करवाना चाहते हो? आप तो ऑलरेडी RN RM हो, आपको तो क्वालिफिकेशन ऐड करवानी है ना.
MSc करने के लिए फिर मेन की आगे एलिजिबल नहीं मानते.
किसने बोला आपको एलिजिबल नहीं मानते हैं? ऐसा कहीं नहीं है कि आपको एलिजिबल नहीं मानते हैं. आप एंट्रेंस टेस्ट में अपीयर होइए, कहीं भी ऐसा नहीं है कि एलिजिबल नहीं मानते हैं. ठीक है, ये चीजें आप, ये चीजें हम अपने लेवल पे कर रहे हैं, वाइस चांसलर जी कर रहे हैं, और हम स्कूल ऑफ हेल्थ साइंसेज कर रहे हैं. जल्दी रिजॉल्व हो जाएगा ये सब.
ये नर्सेज जर्नल में एक बार ये आया था कि जिन प्रोग्राम स्टडी सेंटर्स को INC की मान्यता प्राप्त है, वो ही केवल MSc के लिए क्वालिफाइड है, बाकी अदर्स जिनको नहीं है वो नहीं है. तो इसके बारे में आप कुछ बताएंगे?
आप देखिए, हम आपको बता रहे हैं कि प्रोसेस शुरू हो गया है, वो इंडियन नर्सिंग काउंसिल के साथ प्रोसेस शुरू हो गया, इसलिए आप चिंता नहीं करिए. ठीक है, यू डोंट वरी, यू स्टडी, प्लीज ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. वी आर इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ गेटिंग ऑल द सेंटर्स इंस्पेक्टेड. वी हैव ऑलरेडी सेंड द मनी टू इंडियन नर्सिंग काउंसिल. टुडे मॉर्निंग इंस्पेक्शन ऑफ द सेंटर्स आर पुट ऑन द प्रायोरिटी बेसिस. पर ये सिर्फ प्रॉब्लम कुछ सेंटर्स में, सब जगह नहीं है, पर प्रोसेस शुरू हो गया है. हम आपको बता रहे हैं इस बात को, और लेके आप क्वेश्चन नहीं पूछिए, अगर कोई सब्जेक्ट के बारे में क्वेश्चन पूछना है तो पूछिए, क्योंकि प्रोसेस शुरू हो चुका है. ठीक है? ओके हाँ ओके लेट अस सॉरी बिकॉज दिस इज एन एंग्जाइटी बट इट इज ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड. यस
we'll more focus on the physical characteristics which can help us in identifying the low birth weight babies.
Yes.
So let's talk about weight. The weight of these babies would be less than 2500 grams as we earlier said. The length would be less than 47 centimeters. The head circumference will be less than 33 centimeters. Chest circumference will be less than head circumference and the difference is more than 3 centimeters. So the activity is most important parameter with which you can assess whether the baby is normal or something is going wrong with the baby. So similarly you can find out if the baby is very active and has good movements, you can say that the baby is full term and he is active, he has no problem, because IMNCI considers the infant and newborn movements as one of the criteria for assessing the normalcy in the baby. Then the cry would be weak in such babies. The baby is
Yes, Hyderabad.
Hello, madam.
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm speaking. Hello, madam. Hello.
Yes, I'm listening.
Then Vijayan. Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, I'm listening.
I'm speaking from Hyderabad Regional Center, madam.
Yes, please.
I have a doubt and speak. When are we going to release that first year BSc nursing result?
The first year and second year BSc nursing result of the revised courses should be released very shortly. Are you talking of term and examination? If you are asking for term and examination. Okay. Yes. The exam which you had in December, the result will be out in first week of April or second week of April. Okay. It will be out in first week of April or second week of April. We are hopeful maybe today or tomorrow they will put it on the web, but it should be out within 15 days. That's what our Vice Chancellor had asked, that all the results should be ready by March 31st. But we are giving this 2 weeks because we are not still sure whether the marks have been put on the internet or not. So by 15th April or so, your marks should be there on the internet and you will get the postcard also in a due course of time. But keep checking on the internet whatever results have come. Okay, now let's go. Sorry, let's talk about the, you are talking about the physical characteristics.
Yes, we talked about the activity is very poor in these children, these newborns. The cry is weak. The reflexes may be sucking, swallowing and motor reflex, they may be sluggish. And the limbs, we say general attitude of these babies, they are in the attitude of extension, not the flexion, because they have very less subcutaneous fat and the bones are soft, so they are very extended in posture. Then the abdomen of these babies look round and soft. If you look at the skin of these babies, the skin looks very shiny and it's very loose, thin and delicate. There are abundant lanugo, that is the hair on the back of the baby. The vernix caseosa is very scanty in low birth weight babies. If you see the abdomen, the veins are very visible on the scalp and the abdomen. And if you look at the soles of these babies, there are no deep or only one deep crease could be seen at the sole of the baby. And if you look general structure of the head, it will be large in proportion to the rest of the body. The skull bones will be soft. Sutures and fontanelles will be wide. We have already talked that head circumference is more than the chest circumference and the difference is more than 3 centimeters larger. If we look at the ears, they are soft and the cartilage is not developed in these babies. The hair are woolly and fuzzy and individual strands can be seen. The face is small and chin also is small. If you look at the eyes, they are protruding and the buccal pad is absent. The most important characteristics you can see is the, if you look at the genitalia, if you look at the male testes, these are not descended, they are undescended. The scrotum is poorly developed. This could be pendulous, but the rugae are not present there. The clitoris in the female is hypertrophied. The labia minora does not cover the labia, is not covered by the labia majora. So these are most important. Before going, shall we talk about the physiological?
Sure. Because at least this gives the opportunity to the students that when they are delivering a baby, they'll be able to make out immediately.
Because the management will be based on these. So before I go to the, I will just say, you must remember five characteristics when you are identifying the babies. That is the general posture of the baby, which we said this is extension, not the flexion. Then we said about the ear, the cartilage is flat, very flat, and then you cannot, there will be no recoil. It will remain flexed if you flex the pinna of the ear. The third characteristic, if you see the breast nodules, the breast areola is flat, the breast, this, what is that called as, the nipple is not present, it may be less than 4 millimeters in low birth weight babies and in more than 5 millimeters in the term babies. And then if you talk about genitalia, we have already talked, and there are some other characteristics which can tell you, which we'll be discussing in the next class. That is, there is heel to eye, heel to ear maneuver, there are grasp reflexes, so many other reflexes are there. Grasp is one of the most important, which tells us about the neurological characteristics. Scarf sign is there, popliteal angle, so we are not going to deal with those. Those are more important things which we'll be discussing in subsequent classes. But let us go quickly, what are the physiological handicaps in these children? And then based on these, Ms. Surekha Sama will be discussing the management. The first important handicap is they have unable to maintain the respiratory function. They have inability to maintain temperature. They cannot maintain proper nutrition. They cannot respond properly to the infection because of the poor immune systems. They are prone to develop hemorrhagic diseases and jaundice. They have impaired renal function. The drug toxicity is more in these type of babies. And then there are biochemical disturbances, and they will develop hypoglycemia, hypocalcemia, and other metabolic problems.
Mm-hmm. I think this is, she had just started to talk about the physical characteristics of a low birth weight baby in detail, and physiological just touched it. But I think when the nursing management is discussed of the low birth weight baby, probably Ms. Sama will be able to tell us in further detail. So let's talk of management of low birth weight baby, which talks about the medical management and more so of a nursing management. So how would you say that, how these babies can be managed?
I would thank Professor Vimla Kapoor for giving me this opportunity to be there with the students here. And this is one of the very, very important topics for all the students to be really, you know, listening and asking questions to clarify many of their doubts, because about 30 to 40% of the babies who are admitted in the newborn intensive care unit are either low birth weight or they are preterm and small for date babies. It is important that we talk on the management, which includes prevention and nursing care. The prevention of low birth weight babies is very important, because most of the factors which Mrs. Professor Pitikal had just touched upon are either lying with the mother or with the fetus. If we take good care of the mother during the antenatal period, most of the things can be prevented, and we can have the term healthy babies instead. When we talk of the prevention, we have certain parameters which needs to be taken care of. We should make sure that we first install or stay or make sure that the mother does not go into the premature labor. If the mother is going into premature labor, we may try to arrest the progress of the premature labor by advising strict bed rest to the mother. The mother may be administered some tocolytic agents or as prescribed by the doctor.
They what can are these tocolytic agents? Sorry.
Tocolytic agents are the ones which will arrest the muscular contractions in the mother, mm-hmm. and thereby prevent the progress in the labor of the mother.
How does a nurse come to know that this is to be prescribed? This will be by the obstetrician?
This will be as prescribed. That's what I said. Okay, they'll prescribed. Be prescribed by the obstetrician, and okay. The nurse's responsibility is to make sure that they are administering those tocolytic agents and making sure that the mother's progress to the labor is arrested. Okay. the mother may also be administered hydrocortisones, which are again as prescribed by the doctor. And in case the mother's progress cannot be arrested and the mother has gone into the labor, then we must make sure that we are able to identify the baby's problems beforehand, and we prepare the labor room and have the trained person ready to receive the baby to start the management right at the time of birth. The other important thing is that we identify what and treat whatever are the infections in the mother. They may be either intrauterine infections, because they are the ones which give rise to the occurrence of premature labor, and the baby may be born with respiratory infection or skin infection, which may get into later on septicemia, and the baby's proneness to be very sick and critical. The other important thing is that we recognize whatever are the warning signs in the mother, closely observe them and treat them. We must also keep close watch on the mother's last trimester of pregnancy, because that's the crucial time when the baby is gaining on the maturity. Baby is also gaining immunity from the mother through transplacental route. If the mother is administered folic acid and B-complex during that period, we can also help in, that also helps in neural maturity and lung maturity in the baby, which has been established through scientific studies. The nutrition of the mother, especially all through, it is important that she maintains her caloric requirement and nutritional requirements up to date, and additional nutritional requirements to feed the baby. But in the last trimester, a good diet and good calorie protein intake would help the baby to gain maturity. Advising the mother on to take adequate diet dietary supplements would also help in helping the baby to get immunity and maturity of many of the organs with increased synthesis of the tissues.
Well, I
continuing yes. on the prevention aspect, yet huh? The efficient, if all these factors have not really helped and yet the mother has gone into labor, the efficient management at birth is very essential, as I just said. Having a trained obstetrician and a nurse available in the labor room to receive the baby. And as far as possible, we should avoid administering any sedatives to the mother, because the effect on the baby would be that the baby may have depressed respiratory state, and baby can go into respiratory distress sooner. So avoiding sedatives, administration of sedatives to the mother in the labor would help in prevention of respiratory problems in the baby. Avoiding any sort of intracranial birth injury can also help. The cut short of a second stage of labor to avoid stress of the prolonged labor on the baby's intracranial pressure would also be helpful. Once the baby is born, then in order to give to the baby some extra blood, the cord clamping can be little delayed. That also helps to the baby to get extra blood and iron stores, which are going to help the baby later on. Conducting the labor under strict asepsis to prevent any sort of infection in the baby during the birth or after the birth would be helpful. As a matter of routine, since these babies are prone to develop hemorrhagic disease, as a routine, the babies may be administered vitamin K 0.5 to 1.0 milligram intramuscularly or 1 to 2 ml orally. If it is not given in the labor room soon after birth, as soon as the baby gets admitted to the intensive care unit, it may be administered. The baby should be transferred immediately to the neonatal intensive care unit, but make sure that the baby's temperature is maintained. Soon after birth, drying the baby, wrapping the baby, changing the baby to the dry warm clothes would be helpful in maintaining temperature. During transportation from the labor room to the newborn nursery also is very important. The baby may be fully clothed and the baby may be transferred in a basket or in a manner where the baby's head is also covered and feet and extremities are fully covered, and by the shortest possible way the baby should be transported. If the hospital is having transport incubator, we should make use of transport incubator. This all helps us to prevent the low birth weight baby. The other part now is that we need to give very efficient nursing care to these babies, because we have seen they have...
One question I want to ask you over here, Ms. Sama, is that so many aspects which you have touched, if this is taken care by a nurse,
yes,
that means the complications to this low birth weight baby can also be prevented. Now, you were saying the prevention, I think till the prevention is before delivery, no? Am
yes.
I right?
Yes.
But once the baby is coming out and weighs 2000 grams as per what Dr. Pitikol mentioned,
yes,
then we call this baby as a low birth weight baby, or 2500 grams as low birth weight baby.
Yes.
The transportation and all will come later on. Is that right? Or that has got also an input in, that cannot prevent the low birth weight baby, but that will be a part of care.
Am I right? Yes.
Okay, so I just wanted to make them clear that...
Yes, Jaipur.
Ma'am, I Sanjay from Railway Center, Jaipur.
Yes. Yes, Sanjay.
I have a question. I could not understand about Ballard scale. Ma'am, please, will you tell me about Ballard scale of aspects of physical maturity and neurological assessment?
Of the baby. Aspects of physical and neurological maturity of baby. So that actually I think
it's
is taking growth and development.
It's in the practical component.
Yeah, it is given in the practical component, but we can answer that question of yours. Would you like to answer that question?
The some of the points which actually Professor Pitikol mentioned, that the baby has got scarf sign is present, the popliteal angle is shortened in these babies. Actually, these babies have hypotonia, and because of that their posture is mostly extended. If you try and take their arm from away from the midline to the opposite side of the body, where the baby has to touch the opposite shoulder, normally the babies would be able to do that because they have good muscle tone. And here the babies, because of hypotonia, the flexion attitude is missing. So the baby's movement from the midline to the opposite side is a little different from the term babies. So that is one sign which tells us about the maturity. The other is that when you flex the baby's arm and you find that what is the angle that is maintained, that would be it will be, when it is extended it is 90 degree. When the baby's arm is flexed, it could be either varying between 60 to 0 degree. So if the baby, depending upon the level of maturity, we may grade the baby as per the angle. If it is 0 or if it is 60, the maturity level is graded accordingly.
I think we can add up. What I am trying to say is that there is in your practical,
yes,
it is given very well along with the chart. If you see in practical BNSL 107 block 1, I can show you on page number 36-35. It is given very well, but what Ms. Sama was saying, let's see, Dr. Pitikol, if you would like to add. See, it is given with the chart and with the table, that what all assessment is required for the neurological and physical using these tools. Would you like to add that, please?
You see, this is given in their practical. So what we, basically, this Ballard scale tells us about some of the important physical characteristics which have to be measured in the low birth weight babies, and it tells us about various degrees. You don't have to go into that much of depth of 20 weeks, 10 weeks, 15 weeks, like about after 20 weeks. So there's some physical characteristics and neurological characteristics which I already mentioned very briefly. So the most important physical characteristics, what I was telling, was that you have to see the skin. You know, we said that the skin is very delicate, it is shiny, the lanigo are present at the back of the baby's abdomen, that means at the back, And then we said soul creases. We said in lower grade babies, there would be no deep soul crease, or there will be one single soul crease, whereas in term babies there will be many deep soul creases, but these babies may have multiple superficial soul creases. Then if we talk about the breast, which comes under the physical characteristics, we said that the breast is flat and the areola is also flat, but the nipple will, there will be the nipple, the there will be only less than 4 millimeters in diameter. So you will not be able to see. And then talking about the genitalia, we said that in preterm babies, the female clitoris is hypertrophied. There is wide gap between.
You all mentioned.
Yeah, there is wide. These are five important characteristics. There is wide gap between the labia minora and majora, which is not there in the term babies because it's well developed. Then we talked about male genitalia, where we said that the testes are not descended. They may be in the abdomen or on the way in the inguinal region, and the scrotum is not rugae are not there. That is plain. Whereas in term babies, there will be dark pigmented rugae there. And then we talked about ear cartilage. We said the pinna of the ear, if you fold, the fold will remain for a long time, whereas in case of these, the fold will not remain, the coil will not be there. So these are the important physical characteristics which you can assess. If we talk about the neurological characteristics, as Mrs. Sama has already said, that there are, because there is hypotonia in these babies, and what happens in these babies, one of the signs is scarf sign, as she was talking about. So what you will do, if you just in a preterm baby, if you just try to pull the arm across the chest like this, if you are going to put the chest arm across the chest, and in preterm babies what you will find that this will cross the shoulders and will touch the shoulders, there won't be any resistance there. But in case of term babies, this will be only in the midline of the chest, and there will be resistance faced by the examiner who is examining. The next we said there is heel to ear maneuver. Suppose you are going to touch the heel of the baby up to the ear. If a newborn baby, you will just pull up that heel and then touch it to the side of the ear. What you will find is that you will find the babies in preterm babies, this heel will be able to touch. We will be able to, the examiner will be, who is examining the lower third baby, he will be able to touch the ear. She talked about the popliteal angle. We said that lower leg, if you flex it on the thigh, and then you flex the thigh on the abdomen, and you if you are just pulling with other this other finger and the thumb, if you just lift, extend the lower leg, then there will be an angle which has to be measured. So then she said less than 90 degrees angle would be there. So that is, I think we will talk about this in next class session. In detail.
Uh-huh. I think what the point was raised by Sanjay from Jaipur is well taken up, and actually it was repeated. If you had heard the earlier what Dr. P.T. Kaul had mentioned in detail and given little attention, she was mentioning all these signs and symptoms under the physical and neurological assessment, and it is given on page number 108 also the 4-5 important symptoms with the preterm and term baby very clearly. So spend little time to open your books also, because the practical and theory, all the things are given beautifully in detail with the help of diagrams and with the help of tables. Well, I think doesn't matter, reinforcement is good, and it's a question which you need to know as nurses, so that you are able to make assessment properly, especially when you are working in a community where you find the no pediatrician is there and a place where no help is required. It's an important finding by the nursing personnel. Well, with this we close here, but we will continue at 3:30 on care nursing management of a patient of a low birth weight baby. So we'll talk that in detail. Join us back at 3:30. And also I would request the other regional centers to kindly give us the attendance. Jaipur, Hyderabad has not given us attendance of students. If you make a next call, do give us the attendance of number of students having the teleconference attended by them. Thank you very much. Please join us back at 3:30. Thank you, and I think we'll continue in the next session.